are cracking. We paid 1.6 billion for our embassy in London. And we are still paying 60 million shillings per year for rent at our embassy in London. I need to go to Pakistan, to Islamabad, where we've paid over 415 million for the High Commissioner's residence that is non-existent. Just cracked walls. Isn't it disappointing? This is a crime scene. This is economic terrorism. And we are just supposed to sit and watch. I'm 28 now. By the grace of God, if I'm supposed to get to 90, for how long do you expect me to watch this rubbish? It has reached a point when I must sacrifice my personal safety and not care about the consequences and say the truth as it is, unfiltered, without fear, with the hope that Kenyans are behind me, that they'll not abandon me, that they will stand with me at my hour of need, and if I go missing, they'll stand with my children. Please. Do not be afraid of death. None of us is getting out of this alive. Not even them. We are condemned to die the day we are born. All of us will die. The question is when. And the question is, what did you do with your life? You can live 70 years and do very little. But you can live only 32 years like my late grandfather, Honorable George Morara, and do much. We, the owners of the future of this country, must come out and defend our nation. And the best place to begin is civic education. Without everyone on board, Kenyans, we've lost it. We must find a way to bring everybody on board, rich, middle class, or poor, employed, unemployed, entrepreneur, non-entrepreneur, interested in politics, disinterested, Kikuyu, Kamba, Luo, Luya, Taita, Mijikenda. We need everyone on board. We need a resounding majority to say no. That is the only way we'll bring back our country. Right now, a majority of our country has political illiteracy. They can be hired for 50 bob to shout at rallies and say, tunakushukuru sana, sisi watu wa hapa, kweli bila wewe hatujui tungekuwa wapi. Umetusaidia na umetutetea. Umetuwekea mtu wetu katika serikali. Sasa tuko na imani kwamba mambo itafanyika. Can I ask you something, audience? You saw the net worth of cabinet appointees. Why would a person with a wealth of 2.2 billion want a job that pays 1.4 million per month? Yet, even if he earns a salary every day from now up to 2027, even if we add allowances and say we'll earn 2 million, it is 72 million. What is this incentive? What is this love they have for this country? Wow. Exceptional. They love us so much. They cannot believe we are suffering. They would like to help. They would like to do everything in their possible power to assist us. But no, they don't. They are coming to enrich themselves, to enrich their families, to buy gifts for their girlfriends with our public money. I wish they would invest the money they steal in Kenya by building industries and building houses so that people can have jobs. But they take our money to foreign accounts. They take our money outside the country. We lose. We never gain. Kenyans, you might not be me. You might not have the platform that I have. You might not have the following that I do. You might not be as eloquent as myself. But the little that you do, in the space that you occupy, together, it counts for much. You may have only 100 followers. Okay, you may not even have a social media account. But if you speak to your family, speak to your children, speak to your in-laws, speak to your friends, speak to someone that you meet at the matatu, on a date with your girlfriend, talk about good governance. Spare 5 minutes out of the date to just talk about bad governance and how our country is headed in the wrong direction. Make sure this message reaches everyone, including those who are disenfranchised, in informal settlements, in villages. They've been taught to be obedient to a lie. They are subservient and submissive to a lie. Teach them that corruption affects them. Let them not think that corruption belongs to the TV and the people in Nairobi. Let them know that down in the village, right where they are, there could be a milk cooler 100 meters away that was provided under the small-scale farmers industrialization program that has been stolen right next to their doorstep. Let them know that this road where someone died because they could not reach hospital to deliver on time could be fixed. And as a matter of fact, 1.2 billion was allocated for that road. And someone is enjoying it. There will be no peace. There will be no peace for the wicked. Yeah. There will be no peace in Kenya for the wicked. The wicked shall suffer. They shall not have peace. In their big mansions that they've stolen with our public, they will not sleep. In those beds that they've imported from abroad, instead of promoting local carpenters, there will be no sleep. They will chase ghosts. They will have insomnia. They will go abroad to be treated and there will be no cure. Nothing can cure incompetence. There is nothing that can cure corruption. There is nothing that can cure bad governance. There is nothing that can cure killers. We have dead comrades. We have dead comrades in morgues with bullets shot by public officers in the name of police who are underpaid. Today I put a tweet on my Twitter account. The government said it has increased the salaries of police officers by 40%. A police officer who was confident enough shared with me his payslip and is no more than 13%. And in that 13%, there are so many deductions you can even not talk about them. There is even the housing fund. How do you take money from us, build us a house, then again sell it to us? Is an elephant a white elephant? Ladies and gentlemen, there is something you and I can do. Do not be cheated to think that you are hopeless. Do not leave this for the media. Do not leave this to be just a work of the civil society. Do not leave it for the lawyers to read the Constitution. It is shocking that our Bible has been translated to every local language, but our Constitution has not been translated. We need to translate the Constitution to every local language because even the colonialists that colonized this country, they came lying to us in the name of religion. They have misused the name of our God, this King Saul and his prophets of Baal. They misused the names of our God by telling us that we are God sent. We cannot be questioned because we have been chosen by God. There is God in heaven. But that God is the same one that gave us resources. He's the same God that gave us minerals. We have gold. We have oil. We have chromium. We have uranium that is not to the benefit of the people of Kenya. It is being mined, taken abroad as soil. They say we are taking soil samples for clinical research, for geospatial research. Yet they are taking our gold and we are getting using to launder the proceeds of crime. Pastors here in Kenya are laundering corruption proceeds. A church owns a beach plot in Diani. A church owns a mall. A church owns a helicopter. On behalf of who? Politicians. We need our country back. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm passionate about the subject of good governance. I could speak on and on, but limited am I with time. Let me leave you with this. Mimi nataka niwaeleze hivi. Na nataka mnisikize vizuri. Kwa hii mpango yetu, sasa tumeweka pesa ingine. In another 6 months, nitazungumuza na huyo mjumbe wenu. We have over 160,000 jobs za mjengo, real people, working. And 5,000 youths on our digital highway. I spoke to the ambassador. They are providing 20.5 billion ya hawa wakulima hawa. Ili hawa wote waweze kusaidika kutoka mpango wetu huu katika serikali yetu hii ambayo tumeleta watu wote pamoja ili tuweze kuwa na maendeleo. Ni kweli si kweli? Salale. Kweli nyinyi watu wa KICC mumejielewa.